After 30 years, isn't this too much?
No, it's not enough. We keep looking for more, you know?
They sound just like they did in their 1980s heyday. Same licks. Shoulder to shoulder, push and show. Same lyrics. But Journey is back with an unlikely lead singer they found in the Philippines.
Well, what was that like, standing out front of this group the first time?
I told them I just wanted to go home. Can I just back out at this moment? Like, because I saw the people, it's like among those people. Like, just give me a ticket back
We're
to
like,
the Philippines.
No, get out like, there.
40-year-old Arnel Pineda isn't going back home anytime soon. And starting next week, he'll be seeing a lot more crowds like this one in Las Vegas when Journey embarks on a worldwide tour.
It's all brand new with this new friend, but it's also like we've returned to where we left off. It's just so familiar and settled and comfortable now. Right? Yeah. We got the magic back.
Bass player Ross Valerie remembers Journey in its stonewashed denim pin-up, selling out stadiums and scoring 8 multi-platinum albums. All on the soaring tenor of singer Steve Perry. But when Perry needed a hip replacement in 1996, the band says it waited well over a year for him to have surgery. When he didn't, they replaced him. A split that remains painful, says founding member Neil Sean.
I've been trying to call him for a long time and just does not want to speak. And so we go through channels. We have to go through attorneys, which is really a drag. I like to just be able to pick up the telephone and say, hey, you know, how you doing? Are you comfortable again?
And Journey's fans treasured Perry's voice, too. The two other lead singers who joined the band in the past decade never captured the Perry magic.
I went ahead and ordered something for the table.
So last summer, when the band's 1981 signature hit, Don't Stop Believin', closed the much-anticipated finale of HBO's The Sopranos, viewers were left wondering not only what happened to Tony, but whatever happened to Journey.
You guys didn't even have a singer.
Yeah, that's true.
What was that like, thinking, hey, we can't rush out on the road right now?
That drove me nuts. I couldn't take it. I was going crazy.
They couldn't hit the road, but in desperation, Neil Sean hit the information superhighway that could take Journey into the future by doing justice to its past.
What I was looking for, and what I think what we were looking for, was the legacy sound. It's a tenor voice, you know, with soul and emotion and able to sing a ballad.
Where did he find that voice? On YouTube. After 2 days of surfing, he stumbled on a video of Arnel Pineda singing with The Zoo, a cover band in the Philippines, mimicking everybody from Sting Roxanne, you don't have to pull on the red line. Hey, mama said, where you move? To Led Zeppelin. But when he did Journey, it was a revelation. Neil picked up the phone immediately and called keyboard player Jonathan Cain.
It was 12 o'clock at night. I had a couple glasses of wine in me, and I was like, you got to be kidding me, Neil, right now. He goes, right now, go to the computer.
Arnel couldn't believe it when he got a phone call from his American idols.
Like, are you really Neil Sean? Like, can I see you in webcam? I was asking him, like, come on, I got
to
see
you. Neil asked Arnel to fly to the U.S. for an audition. But when Arnel applied for a visa, he didn't expect to be auditioning for the immigration officer, too.
So you go in and you tell them what? My reason for going to the United States is?
Audition for Journey. And then they were like, Really? Journey, as in Journey, the band? And then he asked me if I happen to know Wheel in the Sky. I just sang it right away, like, Wheel in the Sky isn't turning. As in, and everybody there was like, they looked at me as if they were so surprised. Whoa, what is he singing for?
Anyway, I hope the paperwork come along.
Yeah.
Journey's stamp of approval came almost as fast. The band says it knew right away Arnel possessed not just the voice, but the emotion and soul their songs needed. What they wouldn't discover until later was why.
Since I was 5 years old, when my mom was still alive, she would just call me. And, you know, we listened to the radio with Barbara Streisand and Karen Carpenter, and she would ask me to sing with her.
His parents were both tailors, and Arnel, the oldest of four boys, always knew when his father walked towards him with a tape measure, it meant new clothes for another singing contest.
I would run away. No contest for me. I hate it. I'm so shy, because I was very, very shy. I can only sing really loud when I'm beside my mother.
But Arnel's mother died when he was just 13 after a long illness that left the family bankrupt. Arnel ended up homeless, sleeping in a Manila park, collecting scrap metal to get enough money to eat.
For 3 days, I only have a pocket of biscuit with me. I have to keep it really warm because in 3 days, that'll be my food.
It wasn't until he was older, crooning in Hong Kong nightclubs, that he realized his mother had already given him the only thing he needed to survive.
She taught you to sing?
Yes. I think it's her voice that carried me all through this pain that I've gone through, and she'll always be my biggest influence. You know, she taught me how to fight the world. You know, when it's just not too kind on you. I mean, so she was everything to me.
She's got to be pretty proud right now.
I think so.
Ironically, the man they hired to keep Journey just the same has changed them in ways they couldn't have imagined.
Arnel makes me a better guy.
Amen.
Just knowing him, you know.
Journey's new CD, Revelation, arrives this week. The three-disc package includes 11 brand new songs and 11 re-recorded classics, plus a live DVD of that concert in Las Vegas, one heavily attended by Journey's newest fans. How hardcore fans receive this new Journey remains to be seen, especially those for whom Steve Perry will always be the voice.
He set the bar. He's left us with a very highly valued legacy of music. And the way I think we all feel now is we have someone to honor that with.
And their Filipino frontman is not just singing those Journey songs, he's living them.
Just don't give up. I mean, don't stop believing.
Amen.
Hello, Anderson residence.
Up next, a final bow.
Oh, foolish me.